Dear viewers, this video is not intended for younger audiences due to the critical nature, mature themes, in some cases, and adult language used. Raven Pine's commentaries are made for the purposes of critique, entertainment, and educational value. Any pot shots, insults, or edifice of anger are made for comedic effect and are not done in any way to attack the person or people I cover in these videos. If it offends anyone, I apologize for that, as it is not my overall intent. I ask those watching the video, those that I commentate on, to be respectful and to not fight over this or any other subjects will be discussed further down the line. Thank you for your cooperation. Sincerely, the creator of this video.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have some good news, and we have some bad news.
What's the news?
The good news is Raven's first assignment went over really well.
Thank God! Where is the journey going to take her next?
Well, that's the bad news.
I'll take a double triple bossy deluxe on a raft, 4x4 animal style, extra shingles with a shimmy and a squeeze. Light axle grease, make it cry, burn it, and let it swim.
Sir, this is a Wendy's. Get out of the line.
Rough day, huh?
Yeah, pretentious customers left and right, especially during lunch rush. Besides, your line is pretty much dead anyways.
There's one poor girl standing in line. Hi, welcome to Wendy's. How can I help you?
Hello. I would like a medium set of Baconator combo with fries and a Sprite, plus a small chocolate frosty, please.
For here or to go?
I'll take that to go.
That'll be $8.59. And $1.41 is your change.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Hello, Mojo.
Huh? Oh! Hello?
Hi, Raven. This is Mike speaking.
Oh, hey, Mike. What's going on?
Well, everyone in headquarters decided that maybe it's time for us to see how you do in a solo situation.
Oh, that's nice. What did you guys have in mind?
We have a one-shot commentary we want you to look at. It should be emailed to you now.
I've got a medium sun of Baconator combo with fries, Sprite, and a small chocolate frosty.
That's mine! I gotta go. I'm taking my lunch to headquarters.
Alrighty. See you in headquarters. Peace be with you.
And also with you. Oh, looks like this video is pretty bad. I guess the commentary is in order. A new commentary fresh out of the oven. This is Gumdrop Animator. Some of you watching this may remember her from when she did a video on my god-awful Onision commentary back in 2018. For further context, a user who goes by the name of Beethoven made a video regarding the latest Studio Ghibli movie, Earwig and the Witch. 1 month after the film's official release in the US, Gumdrop released a one-shot commentary on that video, and this is where I come in. I enjoyed her commentary on me, but I really feel that she missed the mark with this one-shot in particular. Just to make things clear, I do not hate her by any means. This is simply to give her some criticism while entertaining and educating my audience. Are we cool with that? Okay, now, without further hesitation, let's go make some owl magic.
You're telling me that if I open this door right now—
Fine, open it.
How do you know what's good for me?
That's my opinion!
We got new information on the new Studio Ghibli film. It's not traditional. Not at all. The movie is completely CGI. Throughout the history of Studio Ghibli, or Ghibli, as some call it. I'm gonna call Studio Ghibli just because. Throughout history, it's always been hand-drawn 2D animation. But they're taking the Disney route.
Let me stop the clip there. You'll notice the problem I had with this, especially upon first viewing. It's not so much the fact that it's sped up or because of the chipmunk voice. It's the length of this part. Combine that part with the rest of the sped up clip, and it all comes down to 1 minute and 49 seconds of stuff that could have been easily left on the chopping block, with the rest of the context being explained briefly either with a skip card or just a voice note summarizing that part in particular. Yes, context is important, but leaving stuff like that in makes it feel really bloated. How long is the video in total? Dios mio! Just so we're clear, long one-shot commentaries are not inherently a bad thing. They can be good as long as you make them interesting and or entertaining. What's also necessary is providing links to the sources you use, including the video in question in the description, which for this video, Gumdrop did not do. Now before someone says, "Shouldn't want her families to go after him in a malicious way," first of all, that could be fixed with her simply telling her audience not to harass him because of the commentary. Second, think of it like this. What if someone wants to watch the video in question to form their own conclusions instead of just blindly agreeing with what the person doing the commentary says? They would end up digging and digging for the video like I did. I looked, and I ended up finding it when searching for videos on his channel. There is also a bit of a problem due to what he says about the movie in a later video, but we'll get to that when we get to that. For now, I'm cutting all this unnecessary fat out.
You're telling me that if I open this door right now—
Fine, open it.
How do you know what's good for me? That's my opinion!
But it's a movie nonetheless, and honestly, I'm still gonna buy it, and I can't wait for it to come out. I guess this is like a mini rant about why I hate CGI, and just CGI in general, basically what it is. It's like small, it's like kind of informal, I guess, I don't know. But yeah, see you guys later, like, scrum, peace.
This is the least worst video that I've ever seen regarding that topic, but that doesn't automatically mean that the video is good, and that's especially saying something considering how the video managed to take off every box of the
to be good, to be bad
mindset in under just 3.5 minutes. First of all, you're saying that the film is going to suck because it's done in CGI. How exactly is it a proper criticism of the film itself?
Oh no, the film is done in the art style that I don't like.
So, there are tons of films out there that are art styles that I personally don't like, but that doesn't mean I'm going to say that the film is completely terrible and that no one should watch it.
While I do agree with this point on the surface, there is a problem with it. Since you mentioned it, it would still be relevant even if the video was made 2 months after the film's release and the disclaimer I skipped over, it would still potentially crash and burn, since 1 month after the commentary was released, he uploaded a review of the movie and said this literally at the start of it.
So, I finally got to see Erwig and the Witch, and it actually met my expectations, plus more. I know that some people don't really like the movie due to the change in art style and direction. You know, the whole CGI, instead of actual 2D hand-drawn animation. It might not be the same animation style, but it really has the same heart, the same feel. Yeah. Everything about it is a Studio Ghibli movie.
Sure, lots of people don't love the art style, but that doesn't mean that that was the only thing that people did not like. Other reasons, including bad storytelling and unlikable characters, were also at the forefront of the many criticisms with the movie itself, even after the film's release. In short, this is one of Studio Ghibli's films that did not exactly hit the mark compared to their other movies such as My Neighbor Totoro, Howl's Moving Castle, Spirited Away, and Kiki's Delivery Service.
Second of all, this video is just absolutely filled to the brim with nostalgia blindness. I mean, Toy Story came out in 1998, the whole thing was made in CGI, and I'm pretty sure you didn't complain about it then, so why are you complaining about it now? Because it's Ghibli? You do realize that Ghibli actually did dabble in a couple of 3D stuff long before Aya and the Witch, right?
Some things I would like to point out here. One, Toy Story came out in 1995, not 1998. I know this is minor, but at least get your facts straight before making a retort. Two, it's not really the idea of making a CGI animated film so much as it is the execution. Anyone can make a crappy CGI animated film, but not everyone can make a CGI animated film that looks good and excels in visual storytelling. Everyone in the industry knows that CGI can be pretty expensive and can have a difficult learning curve. This was especially that case back when it was in its infancy. Three, Ni no Kuni is a video game franchise and not exactly a movie franchise. Sure, Studio Ghibli did do the animation sequences for the games, by that I mean the cutscenes, but it's not an entire Studio Ghibli project, rather a game developed solely by Level 5 in collaboration with that company. It's not really the best example to give here. You wanna know what could have been a better example to use? Borrow the Caterpillar. Since that short film implements CGI while also retaining the 2D style that the studio and Hayao Miyazaki himself are known for.
Third of all, this entire video was just utterly judgmental as fuck. You spent the entire video basically saying,
"This film is going to suck simply because it's in CGI."
And that's it. You don't think the story is shit, you don't think the character is shit, the only reason why you think the film is going to be a terrible pile of ghost shit is because it's done in the art style that isn't 2D hand-painted cell animation. And on that note, you do realize that there are benefits to using 3D CGI animation, right? Like, what if they did it because of budget constraints? What if they did it because it suits the general aesthetic of the particular media, like say, it takes place in cyberspace or if it took place in like some sort of pop-up book? What if they did it because they were trying to imitate another kind of art style that's a little more harder to replicate, like say, claymation? Or, what if they did it because they can?
What? What kind of an argument is this? Okay, Here's what you could have brought to Beethoven's attention. According to Looper, Goro Miyazaki was interested in making a full-length CGI film, but that idea originally came from Toshio Suzuki, the producer of the film, who pointed out that CG was everywhere, especially in Japan. Goro said himself that he has seen hand-drawn animators with huge talent and have done work outside of Studio Ghibli struggle because of the power to carry on the foundations of the studio's legacy. As a result of that, CG became a good way for them and the film was made without set pressure. I get what you're trying to get at, Gumdrop, I really do, but just an ounce of research would have strengthened your point. I'm gonna end this here because there's not much else I can cover at this point. And with all that said and done, the spells have been cast. Where do I begin? Well, let's start with the obvious. This one shot ended up being a huge waste of time. Like I said before, there were lots of things that could have been left on the chopping block, and the fact that you covered the whole video doesn't really help a whole lot, since the original video was 3 minutes and 52 seconds. That right there speaks volumes. Even if the video was made 2 months after the film's release, we have Beethoven's rather positive review of the film that could potentially make the commentary outdated. As I said in the beginning, Gumdrop, I really enjoyed your commentary on me, but you seriously dropped the ball with this one. Have people check your script. It doesn't matter if you want to release a video ahead of any film's release. You need to have your script checked by people that you can at least trust. That, and you need to do a little bit more research for what you are talking about. To quote a friend of mine, if you don't do research, it makes everything you say rather questionable because that just makes it look like you are talking out of your O-ring. I hope this helps. If it doesn't, oh well, at least I got through the Wendy's lunch rush unscathed with the journal still intact in my bag. That's all I have for this video. Until next time, this is Raven Pine saying take care and be kind to one another. Adios! On that note, I think I should look at the first page of the journal after I finish my lunch.
Let's break for lunch.
Good idea. I am starving. I am so hungry, I can eat an octorok.
Oh yeah? Well, I can eat 12 octoroks and lots of spaghetti.
Oh yeah, well,